Today is video presented by EA Game Changers. Hey everyone, it's Kristen and welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having an awesome day. So for today's video, we are going to be doing a completely full and hands-on world overview of the new Strangerville world map. So first thing we are looking at is the map. I also am going to be visiting every single one of these lots. You guys can see all of the homes, the empty lots, the laboratory, the bar, and like all of the other communal kind of things down in the world. So I actually really love this world, you guys. There's like tumbleweeds that you guys will see that even like go over the roads. And I just really think they have put in so much detail and design into this. So we're actually going to be going into the two different residential areas, the town and the laboratory area. So this is the new laboratory that does come. So you guys are not going to have to worry about getting any spoilers with this world overview. I'm not going to show anything that might give you like any hints, tips, or spoilers for the actual story for this this new pack. I highly suggest not getting any spoilers and playing through it on your own, because it's actually a really cool, interesting story, and there's really a lot of elements into it. So one of the first things, you guys, you are going to be seeing these military vehicles all over the world, whether they're just kind of parked or actually like driving up and down the roads. You're going to be seeing these little pink and purple, I think they're called totally bizarre plants, or just really weird plants. These ones here, they have this like glow to them. And as you play the story, these will kind of like come into it a little bit more. So these are really interesting. Like I said, they are just kind of all around the world. You don't have to worry about them harming you or anything like that. So this laboratory definitely has a little bit of an abandoned kind of look to it, which you guys will see. There's like all of these papers, definitely has like a scattered little bit of a mess. Maybe people are like trying to figure out what is going on, you know, thinking of this story, and we have this little door that is locked, so you're not gonna be able to visit the lab and just like go into that door. And yeah, so that is actually sitting on a 64 by 64 lot as well. And now we are in Shady Acres. So this is gonna be where the larger homes are. And in game, this is described as pristine, secluded, and nestled high atop a plateau. Shady Acres is home to the more wealthy locals of Strangerville. Curious about how some of them came into their wealth. So this has definitely the Strangerville vibe to it, you guys. There are just these really big Victorian, gothic-y kind of like style of homes. Definitely kind of remind me of like the Goths home, but a little bit more Victorian and a little bit of like a miner, or even like, I don't know, some kind of like really just old miner's town kind of look to it. And there also is two empty lots here. So the first lot is on a 30 by 20. That one is empty, and that is called the Cliffside Crest. So that is actually the first lot that you guys see me go over on. Then we also have a 40 by 30 called the Plateau Place, and Rosewall, which is a 40 by 30. The Eclectic Arts Household, which is 30 by 20. So that household is actually the one that has like the three people from the trailer in it. And the Creek Corner Cove is another empty lot, which is a 30 by 20. So that is the one that has that like brick fence around it as well. So yeah, lots of like red rock. And it definitely kind of looks like it's possibly like sitting in a crater. I feel like everywhere you look, it just kind of looks like you're in a hole or in a crater. And it definitely has that desert look. But I do like that they made it look different than Oasis Springs, because I do feel like Oasis Springs has a little bit more of like a flat land kind of look to it. Where I do feel like if you are in Shady Acres, there is just like a lot of cliffs, a lot of this rock. And yeah, this is Jess. Meet Jess. You'll actually see her later on in one of my Let's Plays for the Strangerville series. So she was infected, so that is something that you are going to be seeing a lot of throughout like all of these worlds. And yeah, so you're just going to like see all of these people unfortunately infected. So now we have moved down into the Strangerville Plaza. So this is where you are going to be finding, we have the little shop here. This is Irwin. I love Irwin. I love this little decor shop. So this is actually the place where if you want to buy the strainer hat, it is called a tinfoil hat at the shop. You can buy the shirt he is wearing, and there's also things that you might have to come here for in the future as well. So this is the little trailer park, you guys, which I love. I feel like in all of the homes, this is probably my favorite one, just because it is completely different than anything that we have in game right now. Now, the unfortunate thing is you cannot interact with any of the campers, whether it be those like white ones or the tin ones. You actually like, you can't go in them, but there is one that you can sit on the furniture, and then that little green teeny house that I just kind of zoomed in on, you can actually like live there, bulldoze it. So we have a bunch of different lots over in this section of town. So we do have one of the homes that is a 30 by 20. We have the Strangerville Information Center, which is the library, which is on a 20 by 20. We have the Carpenhignus, which I'm sure I said that wrong. That is a 30 by 20. The Eight Bells Bar, which is a 20 by 20. The Slip 42, I'm pretty sure that is where that little tiny house was in like that trailer park. That is a 20 by 15. And we also have the Cahill, which is a 50 by 40. So this is the library. So this is going to be where you find most of the scientists. So scientists are definitely always like walking up and down the streets of Strangerville, but this is where they are kind of like going in the archives, doing a bunch of research, and you will be able to know if they are scientists because they're going to have these white coats on. Some of them are like different colors, but they have the same look. You'll also be able to like hover over them and it will say if they are like a scientist or if they are military or something like that. So you can just kind of like come over here, hang out. You'll see like a lot of people here, even conspiracy theorists. So we also have the bar. Now I really, really want to get in here, you guys, and actually renovate the bar because there's really not a lot going in here. Definitely looks a little bit barren. I mean, there are a bunch of tables. And if you are looking for military personnel, you will definitely find them here because later in the evening, especially, they tend to hang out. And so you'll see them as I kind of like pull over to the door. You're gonna see them like just keep on coming in. So lots of military people. This is definitely the place to be if you want to find them. So library for your scientists, military for the bar for the military. So I really love this town. This definitely reminds me of a lot of The Sims 3 worlds. I feel like they really have been putting a lot more like detail in the backgrounds of the worlds as well, even though unfortunately a lot of these buildings you cannot go to. We only have like the bar and the library. So a lot of this is just decoration, but you are actually able to walk like on every single one of these side streets. So even if you want to possibly like look for other Sims, if you want to use it for storytelling or like machinimas or anything like that, you're actually able to go like way in the back. You'll see me go even like further back. So yeah. So as you can see what I mean, it definitely looks like we are in a crater. It has that like wall of rock that is like all around us, and we're just kind of like sitting on this flat little surface, but it's definitely big. There is like one of those oil tanks or like the water tank, I don't know. But lots of detail, lots of buildings, you guys, and I honestly feel like this is probably one of my favorite towns. Now I don't really know how much I am going to be using like the Strangerville storyline, because I do feel like possibly, you know, once you play it once, you kind of know what's going on in the town. I do feel like you will be able to do like let's plays with that as a story behind it, but as the world is, I really do want to get in here, do like some renovations and some builds. So definitely keep your eyes open for that. Oh my god, you guys, look at the tumbleweed. Like, how freaking cute is that? And you're gonna see another one over by like the abandoned, I think it's a gas station. So there's just like a lot of these right here. Little tumbleweed, just all of those like little details just make this a little bit more realistic. But I really do hope you guys like today's overview of the world and visiting every single lot and all of the different sceneries that you guys will be able to see. So make sure that you do give today's video a very big thumbs up, and hopefully I'm gonna see you all next time. Bye guys.